The next topic for our review, doctor, is intussusception. So, one part of the bowel walking into the same part of the bowel or other part of the bowel becomes the intussusception, where the proximal part is drawn into the distal portion by peristalsis. Male to female ratio is 2:1 or 1:1. 4:1. So male child, intestinal obstruction, intussusception. You can be able to expect to go all. Peak instance is between 5 to 12. This is the favorite question of the examiner. Why? If a newborn vomits, if a newborn has an obstruction, it is not intussusception. That is what I am going to ask you in the next mock test. That's what? Already this question was over? Okay. Between 2 months to 5 years is the range, but 5 to 12 months is the peak. So doctor, if you look at cecum, you have a terminal ileum, this is the point where appendix is sitting like an appendage. Ileum into colon, ileocolic it can be. Ileum into ileum is ileoileal, it can be colocolic, anything can be possible. This is an example of a colocolic intussusception, where the transverse colon is there, no? It has intruded from one part into the other, there is a sleeving. In intussusception. This is another example to show the presence of a small intestinal obstruction, basically because of the intussusception. So what is the cause, doctor? Idiopathic, most of the times. Rotavirus in the winter and enterovirus in the summer are implicated to predispose to the development of the intussusception. Suddenly you will think something genetic, something congenital. Examiner want to test enterovirus, rotavirus, fungi. If you miss, you are missing a mark. Generally viral. Yeah, vaccine. Yeah, we'll come to the vaccine. Now what are the lead point? Something is leading the other and dragging into within it. That could be a Meckel's diverticulum, polyp or lymphoma or Henoch's colony in purpura or cystic fibrosis. Can Henoch's colony in purpura patients can have abdominal pain? But there the reason is vasculitis, mesenteric vasculitis. And the Henoch's colony in purpura can also lead to abdominal pain because it is a leading point of an intussusception. Both the reasons. So what is the classic triad of clinical features? One of the favorite question. Intermittent colicky abdominal pain. A child will be crying, drawing the knees onto the belly. Classical description of intussusception. Bilious vomiting it can lead to. Anything below the level of the second part of the duodenum, bilious vomiting will be there. Crying jelly stools. These are the three cardinal features, but cardinal never happens. I mean, cardinal frequently doesn't happen. That's the reason it is called classical. Classical, Shakespeare's novel is classical. We don't read it. So that's the reason it's called classical. So celebrating a wedding anniversary is classical, because that day anywhere in the world you are expected to be at home. So classical, but not frequent. But if it is found, it is the diagnosis. Then lethargy, shock-like state, seizure-like activity, apneic episodes. Oh, there's a huge list of differential diagnoses for intussusception. It's a nightmare to diagnose, because differential diagnoses are very wide. But a right upper quadrant mass-like lesion is a very important thing, which is sausage shaped, which is ill defined, Because the induced reception, what will basically happen, doctor? There is a dragging of the bowel, one part of the bowel into the other. So that is the reason, if you look at the right lower quadrant, you will be finding the missing cecum, which is being displaced because of the pull of the induced reception. So that is called as Dance's sign, classical. There is nothing dance about it, but called Dance's sign, radiologically, frequently asked question. How do you diagnose, doctor? Since it is one part of the bowel moving into the other, so there is a paucity of the bowel gas. Then the tip of the liver, there is a loss of visualization of that. Then you find two concentric, one part of bowel into the other, no? So two concentric circles of fat density called target sign. We will go through all those radiological features, but before that, let us first run through. After all, it is one part going to the other and gives different forms of appearances. Target sign, donut sign, what is that? There will be one hypoechoic ring surrounded by a hyperechoic ring. So, hyperechoic center with hypoechoic surrounding thing called as target sign. Then there is something called kidney. If you take, no, how will you recognize sonologically? There is an outer cortex, inner medulla. So also you have a hypoechoic and a hyperechoic layers together, superimposing on another, is called as a pseudo kidney sign, is another way of describing. So these are the classical things. Now let us go through each of this important radiological features. How do they really look like in a real patient? If you do ultrasound, what is the thing that you have, doctor? One hyperechoic center and a hypoechoic periphery. Somebody will see it like a kidney, somebody will see it like a donut, somebody will see it like a spring. Radiologists are funny guys. Somebody may see his fiance's face in that, and he may name that sign based on Margarita or Madonna. So we have to ultimately remember all that crap and go to exam, and not remembering that is not the way to get the seat. How uncourteous is the examination system in India? So all right. Now, doctor, this is an abdominal film once more showing small bowel obstruction is the way it clinically presents. If you take the erect film, then you will see the fluid levels in the small bowel, just like any other intestinal obstruction. Then if you pass the barium, when one part of the bowel moves into the other, that is called as a coiled spring appearance, is the other name which is being basically given, coiled spring appearance. When one part of the bowel moves into the other part of the bowel, if you pass the contrast, then coiled spring appearance is one of the classical feature. Then if you do the ultrasound, it looks like kidney, hence called as a target sign or a pseudo kidney sign is the name which is being given. If you do the CT, you can also appreciate one part of bowel going into the other part, and it is, you can see the target sign even in it's called CT scans target sign is the name given. So how do you treat, doctor? First, correct dehydration, because after all baby is vomiting continuously. You pass a nasogastric tube, decompress the upper part of the GIT where the swallowed air is there due to the obstruction in the small intestine. Then you can do a hydrostatic reduction. If you pass a hydrostatic fluid, then it will pull the inner tube from the outer tube. So that's what you can do. If you do barium enema, what will you see? Typically, you will find that coiled spring appearance is one thing, and a cervix-like tapering mass is what you find, because one part bowel moved into the other, right? So you pass it the contrast, so you get that typical cervix kind of an appearance. But for you to pass the barium, what are the contraindications? After all, it is a case of intestinal obstruction. If already there is any perforation, or if there is any peritonitis, or if there is any profound shock, PPP, profound shock, peritonitis or perforation is a contraindication for passing the barium. Air enema also you can give. Unlike the barium, where there is some amount of barium and X-ray, radiation, that is not the problem with the air enema, with the fewer complications. But ultimately, what is the recurrence if you do all this? Once more, there is a tendency for intestine to move like anaconda from one part into the other part. So the radiological reduction, 7 to 10%, surgical reduction will be 2 to 5% is the recurrence rate. So what are the common clinical parts? If I say most common cause of the acute intestinal obstruction under 2 years of age, don't think Meckel's, don't think volvulus, don't think duodenal atresia, think only intussusception as the answer. And we will argue with some references saying that there is something else, but think of intussusception, favorite question of the examiner. Most common form of intussusception is ileum walking into the colon, ileocolic. Rotavirus vaccine and intussusception are related to each other, and that has almost led to the withdrawal of the vaccine. Classic triad of that currant jelly stools, blah blah blah, which we have discussed, is there in only 1/5 of cases. That's the reason if there is no currant jelly stool, do not exclude the diagnosis of intussusception. What is the difference between Davidson and Harrison's internal medicine textbook? Davidson will tell that this is seen everywhere. Harrison will ultimately, when you read, will say anything can be seen, but diagnosis is possible even if nothing is seen. To tell that nothing is seen, Harrison became a fatter book. To tell everything is seen, Davidson is still a smaller book. That is what is all about, doctor. So tomorrow, as a clinician also, you need to have more knowledge to say that there is no problem. And you don't need knowledge at all to say that there is problem. You read Google, little abdominal distension can be diagnosed as pregnancy. That's what journalists are diagnosing the heroines' pregnancies, right? If they develop little bump, they will start talking about she is carrying 6th month or 7th month. Probably in one party she had a little Coca-Cola, had vomiting, they will interpret as hyperemesis, because Google says vomiting is seen in pregnancy. So that's the point. Then neurological signs, lethargy, seizures, etc. They may delay the diagnosis of intussusception. Who will suspect seizures are because of intussusception? Unless the treating doctor is a neurologist and his wife is a gastroenterologist, in a dinner time they were talking about the patient whom he has seen in the hospital. Very rare. So barium enema is both diagnostic and therapeutic. And what is the rule of three about the barium, doctor? Barium column should not exceed a height of 3 feet. No more than 3 attempts to reduce. Then only 3 minutes per attempt. So these are called the rule of three when you typically use the barium, is what you need to basically remember. So that's all the story, doctor, called as intussusception, on which you need to be very, very clear about.